The Romans were masters of urban planning, and their cities were carefully designed with efficiency, functionality, and organization in mind. They projected military discipline and a practical sense of space into their cities, creating a type of city that remains a model for modern urbanism. The conquest of Greek cities in Sicily and Greece introduced the Romans to flourishing Hellenistic metropolises and the most advanced form of contemporary urban life. The comparison of living conditions in these cities with Rome evoked feelings of inferiority in the Romans, which they sought to overcome by learning about Greek Hellenistic culture and incorporating it into the Roman environment. In the capital, at the end of the Republic and the beginning of the Empire, major building projects began to take place. Prominent figures like Gnaeus Pompeius, who built the first stone theater, and Gaius Julius Caesar, who enhanced the Roman Forum, left a significant mark on the city. Many emperors ordered extensive building activities, and some of these structures still stand today, such as the Colosseum, the largest Roman amphitheater for 50,000 seated spectators, built by emperors Vespasianus and Titus, Trajanus's column, and the reconstruction of the Pantheon by Emperor Hadrianus. During the height of the empire, provincial cities flourished, often modeled after Rome in appearance. Traditional Hellenistic centers such as Alexandria and Antioch remained important, while Carthage experienced significant growth, as did previously unknown towns in the western half of the empire. Members of city councils, also known as decuriones, took care of the city's development and prestige. They compensated for the lack of public funds by using their personal finances and sponsoring construction projects such as theaters, amphitheaters, libraries, and essential infrastructure like aqueducts, sewers, and roads. Most Roman cities were built according to a set plan based on a grid system. A well-preserved example of this grid layout can be found in the ruins of Timgad in modern-day Algeria. The city was founded around 100 AD by Emperor Trajanus as a military colony. The grid system meant that streets intersected at the right angles, creating square or rectangular blocks. This system was derived from Roman military camps known as castra, ensuring the easy movement of soldiers, supplies, and inhabitants. The city was centered around two main streets. The first one was Cardo Maximus, the north-south axis. The second one was Decumanus Maximus, the east-west axis. These two axes crossed in the middle of the city, where the main square, the Forum, was located. This was the center of public, political, and commercial life. This organization provided Romans with not only better orientation, but also strategic advantages in case of city defense. Roman cities were equipped with many public buildings that served both the everyday needs of the inhabitants and the representation of Roman culture and power. These buildings were often located along the main axes or near the Forum. The Forum was the heart of the Roman city, where markets, public meetings, court proceedings, and other important events took place. Residents gathered here, moving from one spot to another, talking, shouting, and dealing with official, religious, commercial, and private matters. The size of the forum was determined by the expected number of visitors to avoid overcrowding or an empty square. The forum was paved and often richly decorated with sculptures. Important buildings found in the forum included, firstly, basilicas, multi-purpose public buildings that served as courts or commercial centers and meeting places. Secondly, temples, religious buildings dedicated to Roman gods and goddesses. One of the main temples in the city was often dedicated to Jupiter. The Roman temple was derived from the Greek temple tradition, but also built upon the Etruscan tradition. Unlike the Greek temple, the Roman temple did not face all four directions, but had a strong frontal focus. Another difference was the facade, which had a much deeper columned porch. It was designed to dominate the crowd below during religious ceremonies or public speeches from the podium. A well-preserved forum can be seen in Pompeii, where the remains of temples, basilicas, and public buildings that were the center of daily life are visible. Roman cities were equipped with amphitheaters for gladiator games and other public entertainment. Amphitheaters had an oval shape and were built to accommodate thousands of spectators. For example, the amphitheater in Pompeii is one of the oldest surviving amphitheaters in the world. Theaters had a semicircular shape and were intended for performances of plays and dramatic works. They were designed with acoustics and audience comfort in mind. A preserved example is the theater in Palmyra, where dramatic performances and musical events were held. In Roman architecture, however, theaters were not only built into natural terrain like Greek theaters, but were also constructed on flat ground. The theater had a semicircular shape with a rectangular part forming the backdrop of the stage. Roman city baths, known as thermae, were a key part of daily life, serving not only for hygiene, but also for relaxation, socializing, and business meetings. Baths were carefully designed with different sections such as frigidarium, cold baths, tepidarium, warm baths, and caldarium, hot baths. Examples include the baths in Timgad, which were an important center of civic life. In Rome itself, massive thermal complexes like the baths of Agrippa, Nero, Titus, Trajanus, Caracalla, and Diocletianus were built. Roman cities depended on a reliable water supply, and the Romans built aqueducts to bring water from mountains and rivers directly into the cities. These engineering structures were often built as elevated bridges spanning hills and valleys. The conduits in the aqueducts were mostly made of stone, since other materials would have been too costly. The Romans used the principle of gravitational flow, with aqueducts having a very slight slope, about 6 meters for every 100 meters. Water was channeled into public fountains, baths, and the homes of wealthier citizens. For example, the Aqua Claudia aqueduct brought water to Rome, ensuring a constant supply of drinking water. Roman cities were famous for their road system, which connected cities and ensured efficient transportation and trade. The roads were paved with stone, had solid surfaces, and were designed to withstand heavy traffic and adverse weather conditions. Gates served as entry points to the cities and were often impressively decorated. In Timgad, a well-preserved example of Roman gates and the road network remains, organized in the original grid layout. Buildings were arranged according to their function and prestige. The forum was always at the center of the city, near the main intersection of Cardo and Decumanus. Temples were often located on elevated sites to dominate the surrounding landscape. Amphitheaters and theaters were situated on the outskirts of the city to avoid disturbing everyday life, while baths were usually closer to the center, easily accessible to all. By organizing everything in the Roman city according to strict rules, the Romans created an environment that served both the everyday needs of the inhabitants and the efficient management and control of the city. The choice of location for new construction was a complex matter. Climate and weather conditions were considered crucial. Before building new streets, local weather patterns were studied to avoid overly hot or dry air from southern winds and cold winds from the north. Additionally, rules were followed for placing specific buildings according to their purpose. This was particularly true for the placement of temples. For example, the temples of the city's patron gods, those most honored in the city, were reserved for elevated locations, providing the best view of the city and a commanding presence. The Romans used materials such as bricks, stone, marble, wood, and a concrete for construction. The Roman city planning system has endured for centuries, and many of their urban patterns can still be seen in cities around the world today.